Freak Show only takes two pings to answer them. Even if they use, like, Owald and waste a point each time, it's still not really a thing you want them to be doing. Use an NR deck? No, not tonight. We had a little NR yesterday. I try to mostly stick to one deck per stream. Though we'll probably won't be playing this one all night. Maybe we'll try a different monster deck. This time it's Gutherin. Yuri's a week after the expansion dropped like flies. Yeah, this happens every single expansion. Every patch, really. Expansions are bigger than patches, but the fall off is pretty normal. Always a little disappointing to see, though. Tatter friend. But I agree, Nilfgaard is the purest, most wholesome faction. No. That pretty obviously belongs to monsters. Have you seen this card? He's super wholesome. He's letting this human ride on his back. He's even helping him up. Such a happy troll. I'm gonna get better. I'm gonna get actual genre targets. Showing him the coins you dropped on the ground. Yeah! Yeah, look at that. He's just being so helpful. Eat the freak show card. We all do. They think they nerf it, but in the end, it's actually a buff. Oh. They're gonna make it so whenever you play a unit, he gains a boost. But you can't use his ability unless you play a unit. This place for more enough, so. Clear Consumer out a second unit. Gonna make it immune so you can't heal him. Makes it a very different card and scary for very different reasons. Oh, spent two coins to prevent one bleed. Maybe he just really wants this to live. So if we play Drowner, Drowner is 4. Puts us to 34. This plays for 9 with the Thrives. Or 10. I have an extra Thrive unit. As long as you're doing math wrong in the correct direction. This is a hand. Can't really complain about this one. We push? Yes. If we don't push, I'm pretty sure we always just get crushed by a leader. We need to force out the Bincy. Plus, these decks control awkward hands in short rounds, like not having a spender. Cool. Oh boy. Swindle. We were drawing Geralt anyway. Do I keep it? I don't think so. We're definitely kicking Plumbered. I guess Cutthroat. There's a chance that Geralt's good. Cutthroat's always bad. Got him. Maybe your shit card's better than his. They often will be. Syndicate on three cards. I don't think that's how that works, but okay. Is it Croc again? Oh my god. How many Crocs have I played tonight? I feel like half my losses have been to Croc. I've lost a lot of games. Go play Croc. I don't know, is he good against Syndicate? Cool. Yeah, we did it nerfing Gerni. Maybe or two more P. They could probably buff Gerni for like a provision or two. I don't know. Granny's still kinda good. Like, while they could buff it, I don't think they need to. The leader's still worth a disgusting number of points. I forgot to use my leader ability. Meme event against Syndicate must be fun. It's not. Played one Demoven game this season. It was not fun. What deck is this? We're playing a mid-range Gerni deck right now. Only one game. The one game was enough for me. It was a very brutal game. Was 10 card down by like 60. Yeah. We ended up playing Hubert on an empty board for 3 points as our last play in a 10 card round. Nothing lived. Oh, well, it's a messed up card. I've never played a game where I couldn't even get value on my Gwent Sergeants. It's just Ewald. Ewald, Clown Man. Philippa doesn't really matter. We're not really fighting over points. So the ones that just recur end up being more important. Redraim hit 25 with full test yesterday. It's a really greedy variant of the Blue Stripe Draug deck. God damn it. So what, he always has Vabjorn on this? I have nothing left if I play these. Die winner instead of total MMR. Well, you're refining the deck as you go. You have to at least have a streak of a good win rate. How many games has he played? Let's see. Oh. How the fuck has he played this many games? If I play this, I can't even bleed anymore. Whatever. How many? He's played 182 NR games. Yeah, I had to play around Geralt. It's been 5 days, yeah. Try to upgrade this. I guess I would try to upgrade the Nithral. That's kind of an upgrade. I'll take it. I mean, your deck has to be kind of reasonable to get to 25. You're not... It doesn't necessarily have to be good, but it has to be kind of reasonable. I played it a couple games last night. It was alright. It's like super greedy and high-rolly, though. I think he was playing it on his stream earlier today. If you want to check out his VODs. What does he have? Did we actually find a winnable croc game? We just needed our opponent to be a Madman Lugos friend. Breaker, right? Yeah. Pretty sure we've got him. This last card is just Vabjorn. Hey, we beat a croc. It gives you that second Azrael target. Necro's gonna be very good in some matchups. They're good against what, Nilfgaard decks, which don't really exist. They're pretty awful against Skoyatal. They're pretty bad against all the Skellige decks. They're bad against Syndicate. Triad Fledgling. Get the Cyclops, the Foglet at the Swordmaster. So we can... If we attack here, we're like kind of playing into Igni. We're not really ever passing. Okay, cool. Didn't really play anything either. Good lord, this is a hand. Hand buffed Nulva. Didn't play any agitators yet. Okay. There's one. If we boost this to 13. Still not in Igni range. While we have it. So this can get Igni'd. We just pass here. Six card rounds. Oswald plays for 11, this plays for 9. It's not like super easy for him to do either. No one plays Igni. That's not true at all. I've played two Ignis tonight. Yep. One of them wasn't very good. The other one got me. The two random Igni players are a lot. I didn't say it was a lot, but it's enough to make me want to respect the card. A lot and nobody are two very different things. Be lost. Looks like it. Maybe. I don't know. How big is tree? Is this playing for 10? Oh, it's not even tree. Not even scary card. We're trying real hard. Guthrum. Mining round one is gonna be tricky. So you wanna kick all of our round three cards. So they're not even deck building games. I mean, deck building games are have a lot of factors outside of your control as well. Little battle royale, a bit of deck building. I guess there's a bit of battle royale stuff going on there. I didn't really think about that. Because a lot of the fights are like 1v1, right? But technically you're competing amongst a group of people. There's no OP deck though, it's fun build as you go. And yeah, that's what makes it similar to a deck building game. It's a very different genre than trading card game. Cares about auto battlers? Plenty of people. Pretty sure there's far more people watching the auto battler games than there are watching Gwent right now. God, where's my Geralt? Okay, well, we went on even. We played Catacan, Boombreaker as our important cards. Either of those are really important. Probably got this. This would be a strange game to lose from here. Ugh. Okay, well, Geralt's nice. We haven't gotten our Griffin in the grave yet. Let's do that now, I guess. I think that's too spooky to let him have. At the very least, it can kill all of my Thrives, and I'd rather not have my Thrives die. Or in the nightmare case, he plays the healer. Alright, it's good to make the game feel fresh, but not balancing when the meta hero pulls Bino at best. Yeah, well, the game feeling fresh is the thing that's a lot more important. Stale games typically become dead games. I mean, I don't follow League. I have no idea. Just taking him at his word. Gerni Smorka. We are playing Gerni Smorka. It's going reasonably well, too. Sure. He's actually playing Graydon. Wow. Force his last card. Cool. Why else would you bounty that? I don't know, man. Just not expecting Gutherin to be playing that card. We might be losing. We're losing. Oh, this deck is so frustrating. It's really good at getting into, like, this heavily favored spot and then just top-decking garbage. We got him. I don't know, I guess he was missing Renew, too. Is not really better than Muzzle, not in every way at least. In most ways. Like, I wouldn't just like one to one compare those two cards necessarily. You have to work a lot harder to get Philippa. Could Boombreaker first. Yeah. Oh. That was weird. Felt like I had to sneeze really bad there. Oh, still. Huh. Just Tremors dying. Freak Show is beyond broken. Yeah, kind of agree. Ten card sounds like way too much. Yeah. Depends how small the nerfs are, honestly. So I could Brewis this, and then the fruit's a little worse. Ah, whatever, let's just Griffin here. You can Brewis the fruit. Hey, Alien Rock. So Geralt is short. How'd my balance patch look? I would murder Clown Man and Elwald, like total reworks, and then nothing else. Maybe a little excessive. I don't know, I just don't think the machine gun removal, the cards like Elwald and Clown offer, has any place in Gwent. Remove the damage part and pre-show completely. Yeah, I could see that. Just rework them in some way. You don't necessarily make them unplayable, just make them different cards. Is it possible you've been successful with Phila? Yeah, Phila's fine. Can't even think of 10 cards that need a nerf. Well, if you ask Reddit. Let's see. Let's nerf Slander, Witch Hunter, Philippa, Caleb, Ewald Horst, Freak Show, Apothecary, Renegade Mage, Bincy? That's 10. Oh, Swindle. Can we change Swindle? Not necessarily nerf Swindle, just like make Swindle no longer a card. I think Bounty should be limited to one on the same board. No. Let's move RNG. Like, the only RNG was Shoop. I'm not okay with Shoop either. Won't be like the Mulligan update where we had 1 week of competitive ST and not anymore. Did he rope? Well, he's sad. You're watching some YouTube videos open beta. You think it was easier to follow a game? I don't know about that. I think you're being a little silly there. I'm not getting a Geralt, right? I know he's playing Sea Jackal. He's playing Sea Jackal earlier. I think he's playing Circle earlier, too. You could use less coin in Freak Show. Yeah, that sounds right. He has, what, 8 down? He had Freak Show 9 coins. That was Nithralbin tonight. It's killed, like, 2 summoning circles. Maybe increasing rule limit a little be good. I don't know. Stuff like Igor is kind of, like, balanced around rule limit. Makes Arrakis Queen a lot better. Can play a lot greedier. I guess I lose... Thrive? No. Yeah, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, whoops. I think we're losing here. Oh, never mind. I forgot what happens to Syndicate sometimes. They just kind of lose. Hey YouTube, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like and subscribe. Over here and here, there's some other videos that you might enjoy watching. What are you waiting for? There's two videos. Just click one.